It is July 15th, 2018. I've been asked to give a little bit more detail regarding the build of the pond and the construction and the overall project. So, with that having been said, this pond is in South Louisiana. It's a former koi pond. It's about a little over 5 feet deep, and the project took about 4 months. There was a lot of stops and starts as far as the build was concerned, and we learned many, many things along the way. He suffered with new pond syndrome initially, and were really challenged as far as maintaining water quality without the pH going so high as to endanger the koi. So that was a challenging period about a year ago. We finally, after numerous attempts, were able to get the coating on the pond non-toxic. And we did that by acid washing 2 times and then emptying the pond and refilling it again. All this time we were trying to keep our koi alive during that process. Quite a challenge. This is the filtration system on the pond. We initially started off with just one 10,000 gallon Alpha 1 filter. Unfortunately, it really didn't do the job. So we were a little disappointed in that. So after quite a bit of work trying to keep the water clean, we elected to go with a second filter from AST, which is a large bead filter. And that changed the water quality overnight. Can't say enough good things about that bead filter. We also added a second UV. We initially had one that was rated to about 20,000 gallons, and then we added a second one rated the same way. We have 2 different pumps on the system. One's a low volume that goes into the AST filter, and the other's a high volume that goes into the Alpha 1. The backwashing on both of them is different. One is pressurized, where we just turn the valve and agitate the backwash and send it out to the waste area. And the second is more of a gravity-fed type of backwashing. But we did install, though, some additional plumbing that allows us to be able to rinse the backwash after it's finished and send out the kind of initial particles from the backwash back out to the street. So that's worked out really well as far as being able to keep the water clarity as good as we would like. We also have an autofill as far as the pond is concerned. And we have a small pre-filter on the Alpha 1, albeit other than in the beginning when we're initially starting up the pond. It really doesn't catch too much because the other filters apparently do so. Another investment we made as we installed the pond was to add a whole home generator. We learned right away that losing power on the pumps can be disastrous. So we invested in that. It'll run continuously. It runs off natural gas if in fact we are to suffer a major or prolonged power outage. Living in South Louisiana as we do, the chances of a power outage are pretty high. So we felt like this was a good investment. When we first started up the pond about a year ago, we immediately ran into the situation where there was no covering on the pond, and the sun was just blaring, lighting green water. The fish were really uncomfortable due to the brightness of the sun. So we elected to install a cedar pergola over the entire pond, and on top of the pergola. We also have a shade cloth, so it spans the entire ceiling of the pergola. The pergola, I guess, is about 18 feet long and 14 feet wide. And the pond dimensions are 18 by 14. And like I mentioned earlier, I think it's about 5 feet deep. Other lessons learned during the installation and the new pond syndrome was that we added 2 L60 aerators to add additional oxygen to the water. Unfortunately, we found out that if you add any type of algae killer to the pond, the fish become starved for oxygen almost immediately. And so we found out the hard way that you need as much oxygen as you can possibly get into the water. I showed the filtration systems a little while ago, and the way we have it set up right now is the smaller of the filters runs the waterfall. We had quite a bit of a challenge with that. We tried to put in the sheer waterfall, which did not work. And unfortunately, we had to rebuild that back wall twice. The third time, we elected to put in the smaller scuppers, and they seem to be doing a great job for us. Additionally, in the pond, albeit you can't see it, there are 8 jets that the larger AST filter feeds, and it keeps the water moving pretty quickly. There's 2 bottom filters, one in the main pond and then one in the basin, which is in a second bottom drain in the basin that provides additional filtration. In addition, we also have the 1 skimmer. Lessons learned, I probably would have added a second had to do it over again. We do have lighting installed in the pond. We have about, I think, 8 lights in the pond, the small LEDs, and then we actually have an LED that goes under those scuppers that you see on the back wall for nighttime viewing. Other lessons learned is that we installed an overflow, and also, if you'll notice, there's a small gate, a grate, on the skimmer. Initially, when we started up the pond, we didn't have one, and a couple of the smaller fish had caught in the skimmer. Again, not great results when that happens. So, in any event, I'll probably take some underwater shots here so you can see the fish and the bottom drains. And I think that's it for now.